The women of New Vegas ask me a lot if there's a Mrs. New Vegas. Well, of course there is. You're her. And you're still as perfect as the day we met. Well, you know what that means, folks. Time for some news. NCR officials at Camp McCarran were relieved when technical difficulties with its monorail line to the New Vegas Strip proved easy to fix. One anonymous official told us a serious mechanical failure would have been a disaster because of the age of the train and the scarcity of the replacement parts. In addition, traders from California are being turned away from Mojave Outpost, where the NCR is concerned about dangers along Nipton Highway and I-15. That's all for now. This is Mr. New Vegas saying, I'm just no good without you.
Hey everybody, TBGhunter here, and welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas. Sorry for the lack of videos for the past couple of days. I've been spending most of that time in the infirmary after Lieutenant Boyd's questionable military tactics of shoot the interrogator. Sorry, I'm still a little peeved about that. And also the fact that multiple recordings of this have failed in the past, and this is take number 5. But anyways, welcome back to more Fallout New Vegas. Ironic that Radio New Vegas talks about the monorail system, because that is what we are going to look into today. We're going to be finishing up I Put a Spell on You, and then possibly do a few things around Camp McCarran before we head back out into the wasteland. I don't know if I'm going to be able to get them all done in this video. It'll just depend on, like, how fast I manage to do this stuff and, like, the time and all that stuff. Now, before we do anything else, I want to take a moment and look at a Mojave weapon I picked up from last video, which was Nafi's golf driver. Now, you might be wondering, well, what's so good about it? Looks like just a golf club with a spade on the tip of it. Well, the thing about it is, it's a really decent melee weapon. I've done a little bit of testing in between now and then while I was in the infirmary. It has like a really unique power attack where if I have 50 and just like use the heavy attack, it just does an overhead swing and nothing else. However, you can actually execute the power attack from third person or first person just by moving up, and basically the power attack, which is ironically called 4, it has the ability to knock back and knock down enemies that get hit by it, which is really good because you can stunlock enemies with the stain and just beat the ever-living hell out of them. Now, let us head off into this authorized personnel only. I am authorized personnel, dammit, and talk to Captain Curtis.
Nice to meet you. I'm Curtis.
Hello, Curtis. Colonel Shu sent me and wanted me to help you look into the recent intelligence leaks.
Smart man. I could use somebody who can operate under the radar around here. Whoever our mole is, he's been slippery. Whenever one of the MPs gets too close, he changes his habits. Our last lead went cold weeks ago.
Any idea where I should start?
You want my advice? Start by talking to people with a lot of eyes in the field. People like Lieutenant Boyd or Sergeant Contreras, maybe. Careful with Contreras, though. He's not above suspicion himself. Keep me apprised of any leads you get. This guy's gotten a lot of my men killed. I'm just itching to return the favor.
Alright, I will be sure to do that. Besides, I got a few things I need to say to Boyd after what happened last time. I am so sorry. Just the crazy wackadoo shit that happened, just, it was insane. And if you don't remember what happened last time, well...
Push your pump. You can stop.
Ow, 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 ow.
Yeah. Let's just put that behind us at... Boyd, how the hell did you ever reach the rank of lieutenant if you're typing on a broken computer that doesn't even have a monitor? And you're not even typing on it! You're typing on thin air! This is the leader of the military police, ladies and gentlemen. The NCR is completely screwed without me.
You're back.
Have you noticed anything suspicious lately?
Now, what kind of MP would I be if I didn't notice anything suspicious?
I don't know. What kind of MP types thin air?
You name it.
Who went missing?
Well, there's Anders. He's a ranger. That one's not suspicious so much as worrisome. He left on a dangerous assignment. Colonel Shu sent him out. Now I think he feels guilty not having any way to check up on him.
Alright, is there anything else you can tell me about Anders?
I don't know him very well myself. I seem to remember that he was the man to call on if you needed someone to get in and get out quietly. Colonel Shu would really be the person to talk to.
What about the break-ins?
Maybe break-in isn't the right word. We didn't find signs of forced entry, but I've had reports of someone sneaking into the control tower at night. It's probably just a meeting spot for a steamy military-based love affair. Kids today. But it bothers me that they didn't break in. It means they have an access code. Most soldiers around the base don't have that.
Well, you know, when in war, troops need a way to relieve stress, and what happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. Would you be willing to give me the controller tower access key so I can go check it out?
Sure, if you want to investigate. It's not like there's anything to steal up there, just a bunch of old communications equipment. If you can find out any more, I'd be interested to hear it. There's something about this I really don't like, and if I weren't tied up here, I'd be staking it out personally.
You know, for someone who's in charge with the safety and well-being of the troops stationed at your main HQ in the Mojave campaign, you're a shit security officer. What about the thefts?
Not the kind of things you like to see go missing. No witnesses yet. I've got my money on Sergeant Contreras, who's supposed to be in charge of distribution, the little weasel. But he's too slick to let anyone catch him doing it. We've searched his possessions a dozen times. Nothing.
Well, I'll keep an eye out for missing supplies.
Good. The more guns you can recover, the more I'll be able to use to shoot Contreras for being inept.
Wouldn't be the first time you shot someone in the back. Alright, let's get out of here.
Or do you always look like that?
You wanna start shit with me, Boyd? I mean, you've already set your mind towards me clear back in the interrogation room. You wanna start shit? I'm not above hitting a woman, especially with a golf club. At least I have stuff to do around here. At least I'm making a difference in your damn army. I haven't even gotten a medal for it. Alright, so let us head into the concourse area of the terminal building. I had a little bit of a brain fart there, because there's actually a couple of unmarked quests around here. First of which is this NCR trooper that you see who looks a little bit out of place next to her fellow comrades. Why? Because she actually is one of the only troopers in this area that has a name and also is wearing a combat helmet. I don't know why they gave her a combat helmet, I guess to like distinguish her from the normal troopers, just the normal generic troopers that you find stationed around here. However, there's plenty of troopers back in throughout the Mojave that have like names and stuff that also look important that wear helmets. Hell, why didn't you just remove her helmet? I don't know, it's kind of irked me as to why they just gave her a combat helmet.
Did the colonel send you? I was hoping he might have changed his mind.
You look upset. What is wrong?
I know. I've been crying. Stupid. I'm supposed to be a soldier. My husband, he's a ranger, and he got murdered by a pack of fiends. Goddamn savages laid his body out to rot. Brass won't say it to me straight, but they mean to leave Esteban out there. I can see that plain.
What happened?
He was out on patrol. Bunch of drugged up fiends attacked them. Esteban laid down cover fire while the others fell back. One of the men saw him get shot. He didn't die though. Not then. They tried to go back for him, but there were too many fiends and they had to pull out. Damn savages chased them halfway to McCarran.
And no one else will help you?
His best friend, Jackson, tried. Didn't even get permission from his CO, so it could have cost him a lot. But he never came back.
Well, I'll be sure to go out and recover your husband's body.
Mister, I'd about given up hope. But you've got to be careful. I don't want anybody else dying on my account. Esteban's body is laid out between some of the buildings, east of the Repcon headquarters. At least that's what his squadmates said. There's an NCR position just north of there. It's on the way. They should be able to tell you what the situation is.
Don't worry, I got better backup than just some NCR troopers. Of course, one always gets knocked out and the other charges head first, getting knocked out as well, but you get my meaning. They're more reliable than regular troopers are, even though troopers are more reliable as I've come to find in the past gameplays of this.
Listen, asshole, I know you're not really an NCR health inspector, so you can cut the restaurant critique routine.
Excusez-moi?
And I want my 50 caps back. Because I looked it up, and there ain't no disease called colorectal implosion syndrome.
I think that's what happens when you drink too much sunset sarsaparilla.
Wait, you're not. Oh, wow, I'm sorry. You look just like... Never mind, sorry. So what can I serve you up?
Health inspector bothering you?
That's nothing. You just look like the health inspector who stopped through for the yearly inspection a couple of weeks back. I was hoping...
It's the glasses, isn't it? It's always the glasses. I've been told that multiple times.
Ah, well. Anything I can get you?
What's there to eat? Also, what kind of health inspector goes around wearing heavy combat armor? Jeez, that must be one badass inspector.
Oh, yeah. You can order up anything you want. As long as it's corn or beans.
I'll take the corn.
Just kidding. Haven't you heard? With a few shipments from home and a little variety, the troops are getting restless for some quality grub. You can only do so much as a chef with just corn, beans, onions, and peppers.
I'll still take that corn. Can anything be done to improve the supplies?
Well, we haven't had any quality meat in months. Everyone in the camp just eating beans for protein. It isn't pretty.
Oh God, there must there can't be that.
Down too, so we've been eating mostly raw vegetables, and I'm desperate for spices or seasonings, anything, just something for the general mood around here.
My God, there isn't enough gas mass in the Mojave to cover up that smell. Any idea where I could find some meat around for you guys?
It doesn't need to all come from the same source. There are a bunch of different vendors around who sell meat. Fitz, the Nashes, Crimson Caravan. We've never really tried to go out and organize deals with merchants to supply our food. Already having an overstock of food, we haven't needed to. But we really need some good old red meat on the menu soon. So I'm willing to divert some caps in their direction if they're open to supplying us.
Alright, well, what parts do I need to fix the food processor?
Here's the list. We've been scrapping together quick fixes to keep it running for months. I think it finally crapped out and needs a full overhaul. It's the goofy machine behind the counter in the corner next to the stove. I'd be much obliged if you could take a look at it and get it fixed up.
And any idea where I can find these parts?
I don't know. Try the various traders around the waste. Or the pawn shop in Westside might have some parts. Oh, I've heard of a place called House Tools you could check out. It's an old factory on the north side of Vegas. Just a word of warning, though. I hear no one who goes in there comes back out. Could be traps, crazy robots, or who knows what's in that place.
All right, and any idea where I should look for spices?
The Crimson Caravan would probably be able to arrange a regular shipment, but I don't know of any spices known to improve mood. Hell, we have a whole research department. One guy's even set up in the main terminal building. They're the ones who ought to be looking into it.
All right. Well, I'll be sure to keep my eye out for some beans and some spices and all that stuff in the future. We do have a job we need to go and finish with Crimson Caravan, so I think after doing the I Put a Spell on You, we might go pay a visit to them. Don't hold me on that, because the last time I did it, I ran out of time and I really just didn't want to push it over an hour. The thing is, I've been trying to stick to a schedule, because if you haven't been following me on Twitter, which you totally should go do, down below, I'll put the link into the video. In future me, just do that right now. Twitter.com/TBGhunter. Okay, now make it bounce around. Now spin it. Good. Alright, now take it away. First things first, we're gonna go talk to Contreras over there, but I want to do a little bit of sneaky into his personal computer. Why, you might ask? Well, that's where we're gonna get the manifest to see if he's been a dirty bastard. And of course, that would also be if I can actually break into the damn thing. Oh good, I got some retries. Alright, well the closest one was flavoring. Would it be so ironic if it was actually poisoning? Yes! It was poisoning. The poison really does add to the flavor. Let's take a look at this weapons manifest. Let's see. 50 hunting rifles, 28 in use, 10 in repair, 8 in storage. 50 assault rifles, 25 in use, 6 in repair, 12 in storage. 20 battle rifles, which weren't into the game until the Gunrunner's arsenal was added. 10 in use, 2 in repair, 5 in storage. Increased Gunrunner's weapon shipments and modified manifest to make these numbers match the earlier totals, Boyd is getting too suspicious. Oh, Contreras, you have been a bad little man. That just leads out to the camp. Why don't we go have a look and talk to him, see what he has to say for himself.
You look like someone in need of a reliable supplier.
Yeah, but you don't look like a reliable supplier. So what are you going to say about that, huh?
Take your pick.
Well, then again, he's got assault carbines, a grenade launcher, a missile launcher, and a sniper rifle. Damn, in the past couple of times I've played this, he's had shit stuff to sell. He's got some combat armor I could buy, but honestly, I don't really need it. My combat armor is decent. I think the only thing worth buying is that star bottle cap. I mean, I will definitely sell, like, the useless junk that I have on me and Rex, so... yeah.
Pleasure doing business.
What kind of supplies do you have in mind? It's odd that we can't say this until after we take a look at his wares.
Are you implying I have some kind of secret under-the-table stash I only offer to certain clients? Because that could get a man in trouble.
Well, I didn't until you just flat-out said that. I can be pretty resourceful. Perhaps we could work out a deal.
Now you're talking my language. I do have an expanded inventory for people I can trust. If you're willing to do a little legwork for me, I could give you access to my stash and at a discount. Many of these items aren't available in the NCR, and you'll be hard-pressed to find them at a better price anywhere else.
Alright, sounds good to me. What needs to be done?
Well, I can't exactly go wandering off the base whenever I want, you know. They're already suspicious. I can hear the MPs now.
Gee, Contreras, I didn't know you had so many friends in the Gunrunners.
Speaking of which, guess your first stop.
Crimson Caravan?
Just passing a little note to a man named Isaac for me. I want to know which girl he likes.
Oh, we're going to go see the Brotherhood of Steel, right? Alright, yeah, we're going to Gunrunners. Alright, I'll do it.
Great, let me know what he says. They're almost a straight shot north from here, up past the sharecropper.
Yeah, I know where the Gunrunners is. It's not like I haven't visited them 50,000 times. Rex. I'm going to take all the things you have and I'm going to sell it all because I just want the caps that he has.
So you're back.
Almost 5,000 caps. Not a bad haul. Alright.
Give me a shot.
Well, with that said and done, let's head out because... what time are we at? 1:52 p.m. I guess we're going to be doing a little bit of waiting. So, but before that, we probably should just make our way over to the... control tower, which is right over there. So, let's get to it. And I hope everyone's been doing so well. I want to take a moment and say thank you for all the support that you've been giving me for the series over the past year and a half. God, it's been a year and a half since I've been working on this. I'm surprised a lot of people have found the patience to be able to put up with my bullshittery throughout all this. And I'm happy that people have been enjoying this series a bit. I really do like this, because this is actually the Fallout game that got me into the series in general, and it introduced me to better, even some bad ones. Brotherhood of Steel. But, yeah. Let's get over to the plane. Now, the thing is, I can easily fail this mission. I need to be sure that I don't get caught by whoever's been sneaking into the radio tower. So I think this is a good idea to hide right here, and we're going to wait, 8 hours seems decent. Okay, maybe 8 hours was a little too slow. I probably should have went to 10 hours, because we want to wait to around midnight to 1 in the morning. Hello, I saw someone over there.
Alright.
Yeah, I'll be sure to do that. Just listen, if you hear gunshots, that's probably me in trouble. Let's see. Got 3 shotgun rounds. Got my minigun. Katana. Yeah, we'll go with Paciana. See who was sneaking around over here in the radio tower.
Lupa, this is Frumentarius Picus. Over.
Go ahead, Picus.
Afternoon patrol enters Fiend territory at 1300. Have them mind that stretch.
10-4, Picus. Fiends will be alerted.
Roger, Lupa.
What's the status of your primary mission, Picus?
Charges are set. Detonation will occur as the train leaves the station. Over.
How long?
Couple of minutes. Over.
10-4. Keep us updated.
I heard that, Curtis. So yes, we found out who's been the one sabotaging the NCR stuff around here, and now we gotta make a run to the terminal because the bomb has been planted onto the tram. Cass, Rex, let's hoof it over there. Now, the first time I did this, I got a little bit turned around, mostly because the way back to the main terminal building, which is right there, you might not notice it because it all looks the same to me, but the way to get into it, I completely walked past. That's because it's the two garage door looking things over there. I thought they were just part of the background and were just like those inaccessible, we just put this here for aesthetic purposes, but no! These are doors you can actually go into. I think this is actually the only way you can get into the main terminal building from this without having to go through the Concord area. Now, contrary to what people might believe, there is no time limit for having to go fix the train. However, if I did get caught by Curtis, if I go talk to Shu or Boyd, I don't know if Boyd does count, the train will take off and we will pretty much fail this part of the quest. And oddly enough that there are no NCR troopers stationed where the train usually is. I guess it's because if you're just doing this to get more favorable reputation with the NCR and the troopers there do like check you if like if you have low reputation they won't allow you onto the train area, then they just took them away just so that they don't stop you and you can just get in here easily. I don't know, but either way I'm calling incompetence. This device looks as though it is armed and could go off at any moment. Explosives 35 or higher or science of 45 or higher are required to defuse. Good thing that I excel in both of those, so let's defuse this charge. And that was easy. Sorry Cass, sorry Rex, we can't go on a train ride. Don't worry, we'll be able to go on a little choo-choo train ride in the near future. I don't know. I may do it just for funsies. God, did I actually just use the word funsies? God, I'm so white. But let us go report what we found to Colonel Shu. You know what? After that harrowing rescue of the train, I deserve a little drink. Mostly because I just want to get that Sunset Sarsaparilla quest out of the way. I might go back and visit the Sarsaparilla HQ soonish in the future because there is actually a job that requires me to go to the HQ itself. But, again, if you haven't been following my Twitter, which you totally should, I have been, like, keeping up an update of, I'm keeping to a schedule to do, like, NCR, main story, random stuff around the Mojave and all that stuff.
Look who it is. I haven't had the privilege, but I'm told you've been an angel on our shoulder. What can we do for you at Camp Karen?
You won't have any problems with the intelligence leaks anymore. Also, you have told me multiple times in the past that I have been an angel on your shoulder. I've been the only decent thing helping you in this war.
No? What happened?
It seems Curtis was a little bit ahead of himself. He's been a legionnaire all this time, and I can prove he's tried to blow up the monorail.
Curtis? He's been in the NCR long before a conflict with the Legion. There's just no way. I hope you're mistaken, but somehow I don't think so. It'd explain a lot. This is much worse than anyone expected. There could be others, too. You've done everything that was asked of you. You have my personal thanks for this. And I'll make sure you receive the credit you deserve. I'll have Curtis taken into custody. If he lets himself be taken alive, that is.
Well, it's good to see that dumbass Curtis is getting what's coming to him. Seriously! The only reason he got found out was because he directed me to Boyd, who had a suspicion of something going on in the radio tower. So, the entire him of getting caught and all this, completely his fault. He could have just said, I haven't been able to find any decent leads, and that would have completely thrown me off the trail, but no, he directed me to Boyd. So I'm going to make fun of him for that, and if I see him in jail, I'm going to point and laugh at him. Alright, so let's see what we have to level up. Alrighty, so I put one in the barter just so I can get at an even 65 because I like to go in increments of 5 when I level up. Unless it's like close to 100, in that case I'll just pour what's left into it. I put lockpick at 80 so we can start leveling that up to get those super hard locks out of the way so I can also pick up another Mojave weapon, which is required of 100 lockpick. I got repair to 80 because that will be required to fix that food processor back in the Concord area for the chef, so... Plus, I think there's actually a perk if I can get repair up to 90, so we're going to be taking a look at that next level up. And I got science up to 90, that way We can get that much closer. I might pump in 10 into science just so that I can get the max 100, so that way no terminal will be out of my reach. I don't know what I'll do next time. Maybe I'll focus a bit on medicine and also guns, because I do want to get those up. I don't know how much more I need to put into explosives, because there is a quest that requires me to get high explosives, so I'll look into that in between videos. But yeah, that's what I'm going to go with. And now that we've reached level 24, let's see what we can upgrade via perks. Alright, so I did a little bit of research, and I think I'm going to go with Adamantium Skeleton. With Adamantium Skeleton perk, your limbs only receive half the damage they normally would. And to be honest, I have had a bit of a trouble when it comes to my bones breaking in combat. I have been thinking about getting weapon handling, that way the strength requirement is now 2 points lower than normally would, but however, I haven't really had any issue when it comes to a strength requirement for weapons. Honestly, I don't even think it exists in that game, in this game. Unless, like, it says, like, strength needs to be less than 10, but whatever. I'm gonna go with Adamantium Skeleton. Hopefully we can start getting better perks down the road, but I think, I need to start pumping it, more stuff into the different stuff, unless I do like level 40, level 50, all that stuff. So yeah, Adamantium Skeleton, let's get going. And with that, we are almost done with everything in Camp McCarran. Now, you might be thinking I might be doing an alternates and extras in this video to cover what we've done this and last. However, there is one last major job in Camp McCarran which requires us to go to the vault nearby. So I'm going to save the alternates and extras for that, just so that I don't have to do it for every video, and it's better to just, like, clump it all into one, like, big video. But for now, we're going to make our way to, what are we at? Well, we're less than half an hour. So yeah, we got plenty of time to go to the Crimson Caravan, the Gunrunners. And we'll go talk to Isaac, not Clark, there. Hello, Isaac. I was told to say what kind of girl that you like. However, I am not the most subtle person in the Mojave, so Contreras sent me McCarran needs more guns and ammo.
Shit, is he serious? A 25% increase in weapons is doable, but a 50% increase in ammunition is nuts. Just don't have the supplies on hand to meet that kind of demand for new weapons.
Damn it, if only... Barter 70? Oh yeah, my hat probably ups... barter by 5, I forgot about that. Gunrunners are skilled enough to refurbish weapons like new, right? You're overthinking this.
You're right. I suppose we could refurbish used and damaged weapons to fill the order. They'll be in like new condition, and then we can use our loader to make fresh ammo from spent brass. We'll have to wait a few days for gunpowder, but this might just work out. Tell Contreras the extra guns and ammo will be in the next shipment.
Alright, will do. You know what? Why don't we indulge ourselves and buy a couple of guns from Vendortron?
Do you wish to purchase something?
Yes, I do wish to purchase something. Let's see what we can buy with our hard-earned caps. Actually, how much is medicine stick? Is it still 2,500? Oh, it's 2,400. Wow, that little bit into barter really went a long way in knocking down 1,000 caps. Alright, let's see what I can get. Alrighty then, so I went ahead and I got two new mods for my hunting shotgun. I got the choke and I got the long tube. I also picked up a plethora of shotgun ammo for it, so we'll get to experiment sometime in the future. But that's one good to go with. Sadly, I'm down 4,000 caps. Actually, that was pretty much the same amount of caps I sold from my transaction with Contreras. So it all evens out in the same. But, ladies and gentlemen, returning after its very long absence, that is indeed TBG applies a couple of brand new mods. Oh, look at that. Oh, look at this beautiful shotgun. Actually, the barrel doesn't even look that different. I guess the railing on top or whatever. But also, look at the little choke at the end. Look at how small it is. Look at the tiny little thing. It's so adorable. Alright, even if a weapon of death and destruction is considered adorable. Where the hell did Cass and... Oh, there you are. Cass, I need you to wait here because I don't trust you because you'll get a little gun-ho when you're not drunk. God damn it, did Rex get left behind again? What am I gonna do with that dog? Yeah, it's just Cass and Isaac. I'm gonna send Rex back to the 38 and pick up Eddie next time. Alright, so you might be wondering why we're gonna be breaking into Gunrunner HQ. Well, since we're here, I thought we might as well, you know, have Alice depend on me a bit. We need to break into Gunrunner HQ and steal their manufacturing specifications. Thing is that it's guarded, and if I do this, it required Isaac getting killed, and I will probably fail the unmarked quest. So, to counteract that, I'm going to be using my... Where are you? I think I went way past it. I'm going to be using my Stealth Boy, and I'm also going to use my... Where is it? Oh, La Fantomia comic book to upgrade Sneak a little bit. Because we're going to break in, and we're going to do this quietly. Nice and quiet. Sneaky, 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 sneaky. Don't mind me, just breaking in, just enacting a little bit of corporate espionage. Rex, what the hell? Jeez, dog, you're more unreliable than trying to teach a Deathclaw how to write. I don't know. Got ourselves a nice little assault carbine. Ooh, plasma pistol, nice. Well, that's screwed. Nothing there. Junk. Gunrunner terminal. Let's download the manufacturing specifications. Why don't we read this? Get a little bit of backstory on the Gunrunners. Seriously, can we stop calling the quest log to get over the typing thingamabob? Thank you. Vendortron a Vendortron. Let's give the thing a proper name. Like Bob. We're not calling it Bob. We'll vote on it at the end of the week. Please, please come up with something decent. Why don't we call him Phil? That's not Bob. That seems better. Camp McCarran order number 172. 7 missile launchers and 200 missiles. Damn. We'd like this order expedited. If possible, the situation at the dam requires it. Persona non grata. One of the Crimson Caravan guards, identified as Robert Wilson, decided it would be funny to take a shot at our Vendortron. He's lucky he didn't get a .308 through his idiot skull. We're currently negotiating with McLaughlin for repercussions, but in the meantime, we need to update the Vendortron's recognition software to filter all Crimson Caravan employees. We'll also need to pull some strings over at McCarran and get them temporarily barred from purchasing ammo there as well. So it seems Gunrunners and Crimson Caravan have been going at odds against each other. That might prove useful in terms of turning them against each other. Alright, now I need to get the hell out of here before this stealth boy runs out, because I do not want to just, like, come right out, be right next to the guard and say, "Hey, how's it going? Don't mind me. Just passing through, just causing a little bit of larceny. And don't mind the random robo-dog that you see just walking through there. And don't mind the guy who's just closed the gate magically that no one was around to close." Alright, so now that we got that done, we're going to be doing the words that I probably should never utter. We're going back to Freeside! Yeah, I told you we weren't done with Freeside, as much as I wish we were. Man, I've been to Freeside more than I've been out into the wasteland. Now, the reason we're going back to Freeside is because one of the people that we need to talk to for Alice is there, and finally my stealth boy. Rex, where the hell are you? Rex? Rex, get back here! Rex! Rex! Where are you going? Alright. Now, the thing about this is, I'm going to be running into a little bit of unwanted accompaniment. Because, as you see, the Silver Rush Crier has changed to red. In getting the stuff for the evidence against Silver Rush and stuff, Crimson Caravan, they don't mind. They're more diplomatic than it comes to Silver Rush. However, Silver Rush, yeah, you're outright vilified. Okay, Action Trash Can. Wow. Action Trash Can. Thanks for blocking my shot. Yeah, Silver Rush instantly turns hostile, so that means I can no longer get my wood from them. Sad. Sad indeed. I have to pay respects to my wood. But, yeah. They'll just shoot you on sight. Basically, word gets out that you're the one who managed to get the evidence that put them against the NCR, so they're a little bit angry at me. So they send out all the dudes. Thankfully, wow, I just popped him like a grape. Way to go, Rex. You actually were useful for once. Yeah, the Van Graffs, they don't like me anymore. Which means I failed Birds of a Feather, which, to be honest, I was never even going to do anyway, so nothing of value was lost. Ugh. Where'd Slimin go? Oh, there he is. See, this is what happens when you don't send me to do things that I don't think is ethical, even though I've done some questionably ethical things in the past as well. So we're going to give you all your plasma weapons. I might as well give you the salt carbine as well, and the laser rifle. I almost said laser rifle. That's not Fallout 3. Plasma pistols, plasma rifles, and the... where is it? Combat armor. Sadly, it doesn't say Van Graaff combat armor, so you could easily, like, misplace and think, oh, this is just some random generic combat armor. Well, we're finally going back to the Atomic Wrangler. It's been way too long since we've been here, and this is probably the last time we're going to be going into this place. I think. Don't hold me on that. I've been known to say that I'm not going back to one place only to end up going back there in the future. But hello, Jameson. Or should I say, Lowenthal?
Shove off. You're making my luck turn bad.
Well, guess what? Your luck's about to get worse. I'm here to talk about ending your employment with the Crimson Caravan.
Fuck no. No matter what that old bitch McLafferty says, my dad said I could be in charge of the New Vegas branch. Besides, I got into a little money trouble with the Omertas. If I quit the Crimson Caravan, how am I supposed to get the money to gamble?
Oh, you're one of those people, the rich, spoiled, snobby kid type that my daddy can buy and sell people. Well, you know, the NCR thinks pretty highly of me. Let's say I put a good word into your parents. That would be the nice way. However, I can pass this speech check. So, you don't have the Omerta's money yet, huh? I guess I'll let them know about that. You know what? Just for the attitude you gave me, I'm gonna put a little bit of fear of God into you.
What? No, no, wait. Look, I just need time. Don't rat me out to them. You want me to quit the Crimson Caravan? Fine, I quit. You can tell McLafferty that she won't see my face again.
Better be lucky I don't see your face again. I've bought a whole bunch of shotgun ammo. That is not my shotgun. And I have been itching to test it out. No, we'll go with slug rounds. Alright. Well, my arm was like freaking out a little bit when I pulled my Pip-Boy up after reloading. That was weird. Alright. Let's head over to Crimson Caravan Company because we gotta get some meat over there. We need to get some spices and we need to turn this quest in. If I can actually get over... Okay, I couldn't actually fast travel until the sound, the animation for my shotgun being pumped went off. I don't know if that's counted as a glitch. Yeah, hold off on Missy No for that. Blake! Hey, you have three things that I need. I need meat, I need spices, and I need a bloody violin! McCarran needs a regular shipment of Brahmin meat and spices for the mess hall.
Won't be a problem. We have plenty of spice traders working with us back home, and we could get meat from the local Brahmin ranchers. The bigger issue is payment. To supply the camp with meat will cause some serious caps.
Alright, so we could pull a speech check or a barter check since I am able to pass both of those. McCarran has plenty of caps to cover the shipment. They can deal with the cost. You know what? Since this is a business transaction, why don't we go with barter? McCarran is overstocked with water and fresh vegetables. Arrange the two for one trade.
That should work. We'll do a weighted exchange based on the going value of meat and vegetables. Water is invaluable in this dusty hole. Let McCarran know they should expect the first shipment in a week or so.
Alright, good to know. Alright, well, that part of the quest is pretty much done. We got their meat, we got their spices. Let's just go finish this off and go save Well, let's go recover that trooper's body, or that ranger's body. McLafferty's not here. It's only 10 a.m. I'm going to wait until it's 10... It's 6 a.m., not 10 a.m. God, I cannot talk tonight. You know, you're wondering why I have such a hard time talking, besides I'm socially inept. Usually when I record, it's around like 2 or 3 in the morning, and my brain kind of goes a little, at times around then, so that's kind of why.
Did you... Welcome back.
I have good news. Crimson Caravan Company doesn't have to worry about Henry Jameson anymore. Rich snob got what he got what was coming to him.
Yes, I understand that he's decided to quit outright and not even ask for compensation. I'm a bit curious what exactly you said to him.
Oh, just what needed to be said.
Perhaps I'd rather not know. Thank you all the same. I'm very happy to be rid of that man.
I've always been told I have a way with words. Very awkwardly, but whatever. I have the Gunrunner's holotape.
I hear it's business as usual at the Gunrunner's, as if nothing unusual happened. Excellent work. We'll be able to use the schematics you acquired to begin manufacturing our own weapons immediately. We'll provide some to you at a discount.
Yeah, good to know. Cassidy Caravans has been bought out, and now it's part of Crimson Caravan.
Very good. On occasion, it's proven to be more profitable in the long run to simply buy out the competition. And this is one of those occasions.
Even though you're going to be completely screwed in the long run. Is there anything else you need me to do before I leave?
Something has actually come up. A prospector recently came through here and spent a lot of caps on supplies. Closer inspection of these caps has revealed them to be brand new. This is a problem. The most likely source of these new caps is the old sarsaparilla bottling plant. Go there, locate the bottle cap press, and disable it.
Some questions about that,
what
actually.
Would you like to know?
I know these are pressing matters, but I just want to know what makes these bottle caps a problem to you.
People have been counterfeiting bottle caps forever, but it's always been small scale. A bottle cap press is a whole other threat. We can't have anyone devaluing our currency by mass producing new bottle caps.
Are new bottle caps ever made?
Certainly. Bottle caps do wear out or get damaged. Some people even insist on using bottle caps in explosive devices for some reason.
Hey, don't knock it till you try it.
We make a point to store pre-war bottling plants and recover or disable the bottle cap presses. Seems we missed one.
What makes bottle caps genuine?
Lots of little things. The paint on the label, the machining, the type of metal it's made from. I know there's counterfeit caps floating around, of course. Fortunately, they're very time-consuming to make, so the numbers are small.
All right. Not really what I wanted to know, but I guess that's a little bit of decent backstory of the capping process to the Fallout series. I always wondered why bottle caps of all things become the main currency in this whole franchise. But whatever. Well, we gotta go back to Sunset Sarsaparilla HQ. I'm gonna put that off for a little bit. I might do that next video before we continue on our way. Because I do have like a boat ton, metric shit ton of sarsaparilla bottles back in the Lucky 38. So before we head back to McCarran to, you know, turn Contreras in, we're going to head to Repcon HQ. Why? Because that's where we need to go to recover that Ranger's body. You know, Rangers have been told that they're supposed to be the best of the best of the NCR, yet we're constantly having to deal with the most inept, inconsequential, pointless Rangers the Mojave has had to offer. And lo and behold, the Rangers are right behind us, and so are a bunch of fiends. But where are they shooting at? I can't tell what they're shooting at. It's laser weaponry, but... Well, when in doubt, steady it out. And now I'm an addict. Whoever it is, it's kicking her ass. And take this! Oh, look at- oh man, did he go flying! Whee! Oh, it was a caravan that was attacking him. Yeah, it's always fun hunting fiends, mostly because they're a nice, decent, karma grind. Well, we found what was left of Morales. Hey. You alright? You seem to be a little stuck. And I don't mean by just the fiends and stuff. What happened? Wow, I shot him pretty far. Holy shit. I don't think I'm ever going to be able to make that bank shot ever again. I'll take your lever action shotgun. Traps. Nope, don't leave it alone. Disarm it. Disarm. Disarm. There we go. Thanks for the fire support. Alright, let's go pick up his body. Now, I do like this on our quest for one reason and one reason only. It actually makes use of a mechanic in the game that not a whole lot of people actually use in terms of, like, quests and stuff, which is the you can manipulate the physics for characters' bodies around, which you've seen me done a couple times in the past. It's a fun mechanic, and I'm surprised that this is, like, the only time in this game that we actually ever use it for, like, quest purposes. Hell, not even Fallout 3 had us do something like this, and I'm kind of worried because there is... Supposedly, this is a prime location for a Legion hit squad to come out of nowhere and just start shooting me from the void. But yeah, I wish more games would utilize this feature more. I mean, Fallout 4 doesn't use this, Fallout 3 doesn't use this. They really need to make it a thing. Come on, Morales, we'll get you home to your family soon enough. Oops. Hey, look who decided to finally show up to the party. Look at this guy. Whee! Yeah. You're the danger here, so you're the one who's being taken out first. You know what? Plasma caster. I got something special for you guys. Come on, troopers. Be decent at your job for once. You're gonna die. You are so gonna die. Did I? Oh, there goes that trooper. Oh, come on! God damn it, Cass. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to stab your friend. You were supposed to stab the Legionnaire who was going at him with a giant hammer. War, it makes men mad, you know? It also makes me dead. Whoopsie! There, I win. I always win. There's no one who can touch me. Not in your whole damn army.
Whoa. Hold up. Where do you think you're going?
Are you kidding me? I'm going to take this basket of cakes to my grandmother's house. What do you think?
All right, smartass, I get it. You don't answer to us. But get this straight. You will get eaten alive if you go up that way.
Oh, really? Why is that?
No speech either. Bunch of sick, messed up junkies control the road up there. Got a thing for desecrating corpses.
Oh, you mean the ones who I ventilated with a new hole in the side of their head? Those guys? Yeah, I don't think I have to worry about them anymore. I'll take my chances.
Hey, it's your life.
No, it's your life. I'm the best thing that's happened to this army, and I never get any goddamn respect. Look, your buddy's dead. Not even he was decent enough to be able to fight the Legion. Or the Fiends. What are you doing? You were just standing here letting them gawk at you while I tilt the initiative. Here's your goddamn buddy's body back. Take it and leave it. Well, take it to McCarran, then leave it there.
Oh my God, are you okay? You've got to get to a medic. Doc Kemp can patch you up back at base.
Which guy are you talking to?
Your body like that. You never even met him. If the NCR doesn't have a medal for this, they should make one up.
Damn right I should get a medal. I made a promise to Private Morales.
There must be some kind of code of honor you hold yourself to. You're like a man possessed. We'll make sure Ranger Morales' body gets sent back home. You don't have to, you know, pick him up on your shoulder and haul him to California. Even though I believe you would if you had to. You should go tell Private Morales the news. I know she'll be relieved.
I'm probably the only one who'd be confident enough to actually be able to get him all the way back to California. So here, take the body. I'm gonna go loot the corpses. The salt is real, ladies and gentlemen. The salt is indeed real. You take your damn brush gun. Take all your stuff to sell. I am now over-encumbered. I need to take some buff out just so I can just... You know what? After the shit that I had to deal with, I need some hard booze to steady my nerves. Alright, good. Cass, where are you? I got a better gun for you. Because that terrible, terrible caravan shotgun is not doing you any favors. Especially since you ran out of ammo for your trail car buying. Here, take this brush gun. Where is it? There it is. And take these government ammo. And take these. Take the hollow points. Now stop being useless and actually be decent in a fight. Don't look at me like that. I'll see you all back in Camp McCarran, back in the concourse area, so we can get this finished up, and then possibly get the Mojave weapon, and then probably end it off there. Sweetheart, you will not believe the shit I had to deal with out there to get your husband's body back. I hope you're appreciative of it.
I guess my directions could have been better.
Well, no, it was pretty easy to get him. It was, you know, get the recognition from your stupid trooper allies to give me the enthusiasm to even carry him all the way back to McCarran. I brought his body to an NCR position. He is on his way back to McCarran.
They put him in a box? With a flag and all? I hope so. He'd have been proud. You're too good for this rotten town. First kind thing anybody ever did for me in Esteban. You ever need anything, all you need to do is ask. Thank you so much.
Oh, that was actually the first kind thing that's actually happened to me after doing the... Cass, I know some people think that your companionship is trash. You don't need to take it literally.
Feels better knowing that Esteban's not out there in the waste, but he's still gone, you know?
Yeah, he was a little disarmed in that battle. You might need to look into a closed coffin service. Alright, good news! I will fix your processor for you! Here we go! Jury-rig the machine! Bypassing several broken redundant corresponders, using nothing more than bobby pins, tape, and trooper Swiss Army knife, you managed to get the machine running. There we go. I fixed your broken junk for you, sir.
Howdy. Looking for chow?
Does it involve corn? I'll take the corn. Food processor's fixed.
Amazing. I thought that thing was done for. That'll help me transform what I can offer the troops.
You would, wouldn't believe what duct tape can do in any situation.
Thanks again.
And also supplies. The Crimson Caravan agreed to trade meat and spices for vegetables and water.
That should help balance our stock of food more reasonably and save us a ton of caps. Good work.
Look for supplies.
What do you need?
Nope, that's pretty much it.
We have a whole
All right. Well, that's done. Yeah, nothing like really big since it was an unmarked quest, so you don't get the big you completed this quest like thing pop up. But, you know, it's a little bit of a discount and, you know, stuff. I don't know where I was going with it. Let's go to an unmarked quest that actually will give me a decent payoff in the long run. Contreras, I've got some news for you.
So you're back.
Why are you carrying a super sledge around? What kind of business are you running that needs you to carry a super sledge? Isaac said they'll have extra guns and ammo in the next shipment.
Very professional. I like that. Maybe you can handle something bigger.
And that's it? A few caps and another errand?
You're right. I'm just an under-the-table arms dealer. What could I possibly offer you, a drifting mercenary? Sorry for wasting your time.
All right, what's the job?
Great. The Crimson Caravan has something ready for me. Look for Blake and let him know you're picking up Contreras' medical supplies.
Sounds simple enough. Sounds too simple to be exact.
Thanks. Don't come back until you have it. Crimson Caravan is just
Yeah, I know what Crimson Caravan is, damn it. He doesn't really need to point everything out. Oh, I guess it's about the Crimson Caravan. I guess we're not going to be ending this anytime sooner. You know what? I'm going to get my revenge on Contreras by the end of this video. But not before I bleed him dry of caps. Blake, do you have the violin for me yet?
Buy or sell?
Contreras sent me for some medical supplies.
Here you go. Let him know he needs to make another payment if he wants more of this stuff.
Is there something special about this stuff?
Well, painkillers are easy to come by, but it isn't easy finding iodine, allergy meds, and a few of these other items. Why do you ask?
Combining these with chemical cleaners would yield strong chems. Or some of these could be combined with other chemicals to make drugs. You know what? We'll get some strong chems.
Really? Huh. Never thought of that. The Crimson Caravan isn't really in the drug business.
But it seems one Contreras is. Oh, he is just digging his grave deeper, ladies and gentlemen. You better be appreciative of all this hard work I'm going into getting you your illegal stuff, Contreras.
So you're back.
I got your medical supplies.
See, you're practically stealing caps from me. This work is so easy. There's one more job. It's a little more complicated, but I think you're up to it.
Swear to God, Contreras, I'm gonna shove the shotgun so far.
Just stop back in a few days.
What's the next task?
Well, I'm not. Come back tomorrow and the stuff will be ready to transport.
You know what? I'm gonna see this through. I'm gonna wait 24 hours and I'm gonna talk to you. And then I'm gonna shove the shotgun so far up your butt. You're gonna be coughing up buckshot.
Evening.
You got some explaining to do.
So you're back.
So I am. What do you need me to do?
Well, I'm...
Oh, come on! It's been 24 hours!
Alright. I need you to pass something off to a merchant. The guy's name is Price. The exchange goes down at Miguel's pawn shop in Westside. This next bit is very important. He's paranoid. Maybe a little schizo. You have to identify yourself with a passcode or he'll shoot you right there. Just tell him you're looking for some betting advice. Then he'll say the surest move is to bet on the house.
Alright, well, I'll keep that in mind.
Be sure you do. If you get this last job done, full access to my stash. At a discount, even. Just because I like you. Get moving. Watch out for raiders, and do not lose that package. Good luck.
Don't mind trailblazing as long as we got the ammo. And whiskey.
Yeah, I could go for a tall jug of whiskey right now, Cass. I guess we're not going to go to Freeside this part, at least there's that. We're going to be going to Westside, which is not Freeside. It's kind of like Freeside, but not as shitty. Westside is all the way over there. I guess the closest one would be the Sack Caravan. You know, in the long run, it's probably a good idea that we did this and managed to finally get over to Westside. Because Westside actually does have a few decent things over here. It's actually one of the locations for a couple of important quests, one NCR, one companion. So it's actually kind of nice I can get the waypoint there so I can just fast travel. Still looks like a crap hole, though.
Legion or NCR might not make much of a difference around here.
Hmm. Well, at least we found the pawn shop. Hello, you look out of place in this area.
You don't strike me as someone down on their luck. What brings you to Westside?
Business.
I help tend to crops, stand watch for fiends, and generally help keep things civilized.
How long have you been living here?
I help tend to crops, stand watch...
That didn't answer my question, sir.
Couple of years now. I was a trader for a while, but got tired of all the walking. Westside was a good place to settle down as any.
Why do I get the feeling you're going to be somewhat important in the future? Nudge, nudge. Oh my god, where's that radio? I need to kill it. I need to find that radio. Oh, that was close. Guess?
Hello?
I think you were the one I need to talk to.
Caps, I buy just about anything. Of course, I've also got plenty of things for sale, too.
I might take a look. Might as well take a quick peek and see what he all has. Magnum revolvers, brass knuckles, a mantis gauntlet. Lever action shotgun, RCAW, nothing that seems to... Ooh, storm chaser hat. I'll take that because I just like the look of the storm chaser hat. Merc troublemaker outfit. I might come back here and pick up a couple things. I'll take that combat helmet just so I can repair the broken combat helmet I have now.
Until next.
Keller?
What do you want?
Have you seen a guy named Price around?
We work together. I'm handling his deliveries for the moment while he handles a business opportunity that came up.
Alright, well, I'm looking for some betting advice.
What? Look, do you have something to drop off or not?
Well, never mind. He seems a tad suspicious. But my perception isn't high enough, so why don't we up it a little bit? By that I mean... Where's my Mentats at? Mentats! There we go. Oops. No, don't want to pickpocket him!
What do you want?
Uh-oh. Time powers activate! You know, with all this cutting around and stuff, I wonder if Vault Boy is actually starting to get a little bit dizzy from the whole, you know, 70s Batman, like, transition thing I made. Alright, looking for Price. I need some betting advice. Hey, that wasn't the right response for the password.
Password? That little bastard said nothing about a password. Price is in NCR custody and you're going to join him. Unless you've got a damn good explanation for why you're looking for him. Hand over your weapons!
Oh shit. Wait, why didn't that pass? I said I had the intelligence and the... What?! I was told he was a local merchant and to find him to buy some supplies.
Alright, if you hear anything, report it to myself or Lieutenant Boyd immediately. We need to track down his source.
Son of a bitch, set me up! Oh, Contreras, you are gonna get it. You are going to get it. I was almost arrested by the same people I've been trying to help cover your ass. See, this is what happens when you go too deep undercover. You get suspicious for the people that you're working for. Oh, time to pull a little shotgun surgery on him. I'm gonna enjoy this. Weasel, you set me up.
So you're back.
So I am, you ventriloquist. Some guy is standing in for Price. I didn't inquire further. Good.
Price works alone. Chat him up and see what's going on. Don't give him any details, and do not give him the package. There's a chance he actually knows Price, but I doubt it. So you're back.
Yeah, about that. He was a plant from the NCR. It's a ranger.
Shit. Well, please tell me you didn't hand him the package.
No, it's here.
You're gonna need to take him out. If McCarran hears I've been selling contraband, we're both dead.
Well, maybe there's money to be made here instead of there.
Tell him I'll cut him in on a bit of the profit and help him track down drug dealers if he'll give me a pass. The last thing I need is a do-gooder ranger trying to take me down.
Yeah, well, how about a do-gooder mercenary to take you down? I'll cover the rest of this stuff in the alternates and extras because at this point, Contreras has just pissed me off to no end. All this running back and forth, I feel like I'm a damn pack mule. So you know what? Why don't we go tell Boyd what we found on Contreras' person? Maybe we'll get a little reward, because I am not going all the way back to Freeside tonight. Or Westside. I'm definitely not going to Freeside tonight, but sure as hell not going to Westside as well. Boyd, it appears Contreras is doing more harm than good for the NCR. You need to take him out. I approve Sergeant Contreras is involved in criminal activity.
That may be the worst-kept secret on the base. I'd be more surprised if you had proof he wasn't involved in criminal activity. But if you have proof, you're the envy of every MP stationed here. What'd you find?
Am I the envy of you? Because that would make me so happy after the bullshit I've had to run back and forth for. I've hacked into his computer and found evidence that he's selling NCR weapons.
Little bastard. I'm sure some of those find their way into the hands of our enemies, too. All right, thanks for telling me. I'm gonna have him rounded up. Pretty impressive work there. Wish I could keep you around. But for helping me nail this guy, I think you should have a little keepsake. Here. It's not contraband, but I confiscated it from Contreras last week because he was being smarmy and I was sick of his bullshit.
Did you also shoot him in the gut for it? I'm pretty sure you probably shot him in the gut for it. Wouldn't be the first time you shot someone in the gut for being sick of their bullshit. All right, I'm over encumbered. Rex, you need to hold on to a couple things. Take these submachine guns and the machete. Now, for all our hard work in dealing with Contreras' bullshit, and I am so sorry that this video took longer than I thought it would be because I honestly forgot how much bullshit he had packed into them. We get... Where is it? Where is it? We get this machine. Yeah, it's just this machine. It's an M1 Grand. It's actually, this is the only time you're ever going to be able to get this weapon in the main game if you didn't have the Gunrunner's Arsenal. Because this is basically the unique version of the Battle Rifle, which I actually like a bit more. It feels a lot more steady than a Hunting Rifle. It uses the same ammo as Hunting Rifles as well. Armor piercing, hull points, nice. What does it have? Does it, I don't think it has high critical, but it holds 8 rounds, it has a fast firing rate. It's basically a hunting rifle, but shoots faster. And, to be honest, I like it a bit more than I've been liking Paciana, so I might use this a bit more. I mean, shoots fast, hits hard, it's my kind of weapon. But, ladies and gentlemen, after all this crazy stuff that has happened in today's video, I think this is more than enough to end things off here. Next time on Fallout New Vegas, we are going to be making our way off to Vault 22. Yes, we are finally going to start investigating some of the vaults around the Mojave Wasteland. I mean, there's one over here and there's one over here somewhere that we'll be visiting in the future. But for now, we're going to be taking a look at Vault 22. So, until then, I will see you guys next time. Later.